Today, we're going to take a look at Excel versus Google Sheets. What a lot of people don't realize is that Excel and Google Sheets are actually completely different products. In this video, we'll take a look at where these two products are the same, but more importantly, how they're different, and how those differences can make a huge difference to the job that you're working on. If you're new to this channel and you're keen to learn the latest tips, tricks, and tools for working more effectively with data, please hit the subscribe button for weekly videos. So first up, Excel and Google Sheets are both spreadsheet applications. This allows users to freely enter data and formulas into cells, pivot to create quick summaries, and prepare some basic charts. Google Sheets also allows you to work with standard Excel files. So if you're a basic spreadsheet user, you're really not going to find too much difference with these products. This is where these similarities pretty much end though. Common data tasks such as data preparation, data entry, and collaboration are handled massively different with very clear winners for these different types of work. First up, let's start with Excel. Excel has over 750 million users and has become the de facto standard for spreadsheets. Excel has been around for a very long time and contains the most built out and refined feature set. If you're a more advanced Excel user, it'll probably bother you all of the features that are missing from Google Sheets. There are still some real benefits to Google Sheets though, even for long time Excel users, which we'll go over in just a sec. First though, some of the power features of Excel actually don't use the spreadsheet model at all, and are actually tools from some of Microsoft's more enterprise products, which have been bundled directly into Excel without that many people realizing this. For example, creating a report in Excel often means creating a manual process that needs to be refreshed and rerun every month. Using the traditional spreadsheet methods for this type of work creates more work and more risk of things not being copied properly. This is where tools such as R and Python are incredibly effective. Yep, R and Python are much easier and more effective for data preparation than VBA, but that's another video. R and Python are awesome tools for data professionals, and despite being programming tools, may be much easier to learn than you think. This small snippet of R code lists out an entire folder of files containing over 5 million records. It then loads all of these files in and merges them together into a single table. This next line here looks for all of the missing values and fills them in with the values from above. This line here groups the entire 5 million record dataset by department. And then this line here calculates the sum for all of the numeric columns. And it does all of this in around 3 seconds. This is why R is such a great tool for people looking to take things to the next level. For those not inclined to learn code though, there is another solution. Microsoft Power Query for Excel is taken from Microsoft Power BI, Microsoft's data visualization tool equivalent to Tableau. Power Query allows you to merge, clean, and transform your data. It records all of your steps for automation through a no-code interface, which is faster and more robust than VBA. Power Query has many similarities to tools such as ALTERYX, which charges thousands of dollars for some similar functionality. To be fair, Power Query really only handles the data access, data prep, and blending part of ALTERYX. However, for a lot of people and organizations, this is really all that they need. So having all of that functionality in a tool that you already have available is a huge win. If you perform any regular reporting, Power Query could save you hours every month with just a few clicks of the mouse. If you want to find out more about Power Query, you can take a look at some of the links in the description section of this video. Power Query is built into the Windows version of Excel 2016 and is a free add-in for Excel 2010 and Excel 2013. Unfortunately, it's not available for Mac or online version of Excel. This brings me to one of the downsides of Excel. There are many different versions of Excel, and they are definitely not the same. Although the latest version of Excel for Windows is a highly developed product, the Mac, and especially the online version of Excel, is far less developed than Google Sheets. Implementing advanced features on Windows and then trying to share your work across other platforms can be highly frustrating. This leads me to my next point. Google Sheets is natively built for collaboration and sharing, where Excel is not. There is only one version of Google Sheets in the cloud, and it's the same version that everyone uses, regardless of what platform they're on. Even though Excel has a shared workbook functionality, if you've tried this before, you'll know how poorly this works and how many file locking and syncing issues occur when trying to collaborate on a file. It's also worth noting that enabling shared workbooks in Excel also severely limits its functionality, even when it's working 100% on Windows. So Google Sheets is far superior for collaborating with multiple users for a single file. The implications of this is that it's also far better for data collection. See, if you're collecting data from only one user, then Excel is probably fine, but often data needs to be collected from a number of different people. With Excel, you would normally chop up the file, email it to people, hope they use the right version, enter the data properly, and not alter the columns. If all goes perfectly, you still need to glue all the files back together. The problem is that the process rarely goes perfectly. Even with data validation enabled, it's far too easy to corrupt the file, which means manual collection and cleanup of the data before you can see any of the results. What you really want is a form. A form that makes it easy for users to enter the correct information, automatically records who provided the information and when they provided it. The form should then automatically submit all the results back to a central data source so that you can report off it in real time. No cleaning or gluing required. This is exactly what Google Forms do for you, and they are already perfectly integrated into Google Sheets. Free instant forms in minutes, no coding required. For data collection, this is far better than anything Excel has to offer. So in a nutshell, Excel is great as a no-code data preparation automation tool. Google Sheets is far better for data collection. There are other differences for sure, and also other tools too. If you have a use case that you're wondering about, leave a comment. If you found this video helpful, please leave a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.